Knights and ladies of the Table Round, did you think that we would not hear the call of Camelot? Did you think that you could leave us out of your festivities? Well, I say we have been preparing for many a day, and our angels rejoicing in the way, to come to that place where we might give the new birth to Camelot, and to send forth the call. This is indeed a moment, for you see, it is the moment when we can begin to weave anew that precious nucleus, that matrix of the cosmic virgin. The cycles have indeed turned, and I sent forth the call for an evening of Camelot when I gave to the messenger the dictation for the outline of the program of this conference. From Darjeeling, I sent forth the call, for I would come to be that future king, that one among you who would ring the bell of the soul. Do you hear it now toll? It is the bell that is chiming, that special gong. It is the song of those who know the hour of the coming again of the hosts of light. And therefore I plant my sword Excalibur here in the heart of life, here in the heart of the living, here in this place. And I come to call my own, that we may now atone for all lesser deeds, and bring with us even our steeds, that we may ride to the castle of light, and there see the maidens, their lamps burning bright. They are trimmed now, because they have come once again to fulfill the inner vow. I am Moria of the flame, and now with the ascended powers that I wield, I can send forth the wisdom and the love that is for the very nurturing of those souls that I long, long have loved. Who told you that we were very far removed from you? We have been here all the while, all these years and centuries. Really, no time or space has passed in this joy of the return, all as it was then, the return to the white flame, and before us the vision of the grail that we must carry into the new world and into the new age. Now you have come, each one, to put your hand on the grail, to touch that base, to be here, a light-bearer this time without fail. All the components of Camelot are here, even those forces of self-destruction. But this time they will be seen for what they are and put into the flame, nevermore, nevermore to reign, even in the hearts of the fallen ones. Let them also hear our call, for I send forth, as my gift this New Year's Eve, an intense action of my heart's love for the will of God. As I have fashioned a gift, it is the gift of the flame of forgiveness. Of course, we have long ago forgiven those who disturbed the matrix of the chalice. But I send forth the melting fires of mercy to soften their hearts that they might begin anew. I send forth unguents of forgiveness. Will you do the same? Will you do the same? And therefore be free of blame of the Lord God above or the Lord God here below. Forgiveness then is the inauguration of the cycle of Camelot. Let all who hear my words, let all who read my word then know that I, Moria, stand. I stand in this place, and I send forth that line. It is the honor, it is the truth, it is the grace and love of forgiveness whereby all can re-enter by the door by which they have left and gone astray, far afield from that energy field that is the mind of God. I call to each and every son and daughter around the planetary body who has once heard of Moria, of Saint Germain, or even of Lanello, or the Mother of the Flame. All who have once heard of that call, let them hear again, for we do extend to all the gift of pardon, and of all we ask as well, that pardon which is due, and therefore in this mutual love and forgiveness, let us begin anew. Truly it is a cycle for new beginnings. Truly from the beginning we were winning. And so, all of this energy to and fro, out of the way of the central magnet of our purpose, now can in an instant be drawn into the center, reconsecrated, and out of that energy, out of that substance redeemed, we would fashion the image of a Lord Christ, Lord Jesus, the one whom we adore. Let then all this energy that has passed through the flame be for the coming of Christ and Buddha within the heart, within the church, within the home. Come then, children of Israel, people of the one God, come, and by the Lamb and by the rod, let us atone. Let us atone, and therefore let us be for the transmutation of all cycles, and then let us see what we can build for our God and for the children of our God. Let us build. This is the age of the building. This is the age of cycles turning. This is the moment of the coming and the blessedness of being. Let all then who have heard of Camelot, let them come. Let them come from the farthest shores. Let them come again. Let them hear the call and answer. For I would discipline, and I would nourish, and I would train Chelas, and I would bestow the gift of knighthood and the flame of mother to ladies of the flame. I would return you then to the jousting and to the tournament. I will return you to the holy quest. And then, one day, we will have our table round, and it will be our physical focus of the great central sun and of the council chambers in India and in America, where Chananda sits and all who serve, where Confucius comes and Lord Lanto and Mary the Mother. There too you will be bidden to sit. And we will have our council of the round table, and that council will be the forum of light bearers who are born to take the light of earth and fashion the new order of the ages. I am Moria, I am one, one with my own chum, my own Lanello and my Merlin. And our Guinevere is here, and each and every one of you we hold so dear and so very near. I embrace you each and every one. Now look for the hand clasp of Lanello and the touch of Merlin, and as you see, the smile of mother who is with friends of old. Your friendship to our mother has has been for us a comfort, and to her the sustainment of life, midst the tear and the laughter, and the walk and the being here on earth. In the joy of the Buddha, we send gratitude for your vigil in the victory. We will never leave you. We will never leave you so long as you love and love and love. Yes, it is I, Moria. And in my hand I hold a cup. It is a cup of good cheer, a toast to the new year. Precious ones, in the chalice I seal you, and I bow before the next king and queen who will come to be in the center of the sun, the focus of Alpha and Omega. I bow before the one you say you know not who. Why, of course, it is you and you and you and you. Welcome, king and queen, prince and princess, born to rule and born to reign. Come, come to Camelot again.